All right. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Welcome back. Good morning.
Good
morning. Good morning.
Hey, lovely to see you all.
Yes,
Lisa's
in. And we should start by singing happy birthday to Wanda.
Happy birthday, Wanda.
I know this is a disaster when you try to sing all together. So
that's all right. Let's have a go.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Wanda. Happy birthday to you. We can hear the echoes.
Thank you.
Happy birthday, Wanda. It's lovely to see you. So birthday today.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome, ma'am. All right, so I'm going to mute everyone, and then we'll begin with the exercise. So take a deep breath, close your eyes, and go into your superpower state. However you do that, whether repeating a word or phrase, or thinking of someone or something you love, hugging that subject, and start to feel the physical feeling in your chest or solar plexus. Feel that expansion and allow that light or energy to shine out from your heart. And now allow it to fill your whole body down to your toes, up to the top of your head, and out to your fingertips. So you're full of that light, that energy. And now allow it to fill every cell in your body, each of the 50 trillion cells that make up your body. Fill each one with that light, that energy. Love each cell just for existing. Very good. And now allow that light or energy to fill the little you, the child in you. And love that child just for existing. And imagine that light or energy overflowing from that little you and filling your whole childhood with that light, that energy. Shine the light into any darkness. Love it all anyway. Very good. And now allow that light or energy to fill everyone on the call today. Love each person just for existing. Very good job. And you can open your eyes. Very good. So welcome back, everyone. Before I check in with each person, I'm going to share, I want to talk a little bit today about the unconditional bit, how to do it, and you know, because it's not easy when you first get started, of course, because it goes against what we instinctively feel. And so I want to talk about why it's important, because that's where the power is, and then how to make it easier. So the first part to remember is that whatever you want to happen. So, you know, let's say my own experience, I wanted to change my finances. So I was looking at my overdrawn bank account, no money coming in. And of course, that's not what I wanted. So I was doing this technique in order to see a change in my finances. But the challenging part of that is you need to not want to, I mean, you need to not be conditional about it. So normal visualization is imagining the result you want and focusing on that. And that's great. But the reason this is so much more powerful is that you imagine also the result you don't want, and you maintain that love for that result. And as I was saying yesterday, what that does is it releases that negative, the thing you don't want, from your experience, because you're no longer holding on to it by your fear of it or your rejection of it. You're no longer arm wrestling with it. So it's very important to do that. And today I'm going to give you an extra exercise to help make that, to help practice that, that you can practice. We'll do it in the session, and then you can practice it over the next 24 hours. So it's crucial to remember that that's where the power is. And in the beginning, it feels impossible. It feels like, but I can't love something that I don't want, or I can't love something that is mean or horrible or triggering me or whatever. But keep reminding yourself, it's not an emotion. It's shining light into darkness, and the unconditional part of that is the power. Okay, so the exercise that we'll do a little later, and then you'll practice until tomorrow, is you're going to think of something that bothers you a little bit. So nothing big, just like a food you don't like or a song that annoys you, something very low in the triggering scale, something that just irritates you a little bit. And we're going to practice on that. So we practice, so it's an easy target. You practice on that, and the aim of it is getting to the point where you're able to keep yourself filled with that love, send the love to the thing that annoys you, and maintain it even if it never changes. So you're going to maintain that love regardless of what it is that you don't like about the thing. And that kind of will build your skill, and then you'll pick a little bit more difficult target, and you'll build up to the big things, and you'll see amazing changes. And I'm going to give you an example of something that worked for me. There's someone in my life who I love very, very much, but he wasn't keeping in contact with me. And so it was really, I was worried. I was feeling like, you know, and when I say not in contact, I mean no contact at all. And in the beginning, I was chasing. I was calling and calling and texting and calling and texting, and that didn't help. And so I reminded myself of this. So all I did was, whenever I thought of him, I sent this love, regardless of what happens. If he never speaks to me again, if he's in danger, or something bad happens, I loved it all anyway. And the reason for that is it's shining light into any darkness. So it would have been impossible for me to do it before I learned the skill, but I was able to do it. And suddenly, out of the blue, he started texting me. And then day before yesterday, he called me out of the blue, and we had a wonderful hour-long conversation, and he's kept in contact since then. So that's a little example of, it can be really hard to let go and love the thing anyway, but it is the way to get the results. Okay, so there's that little bit of a contradiction there where it feels like the opposite, but if keep remembering, it's shining light into darkness. Thank you, Cara. All right, so let's check in with each person, find out how you're all doing. So for those who are new on the call today, welcome. And just to let you know, if you don't have your camera on, I won't come to you to ask you how you're doing or anything, because in case you want to remain incognito. So if you do want to speak, you can just unmute yourself, or you can put it in the chat. If you put it in the chat and you don't say it's okay to use your name, then I won't mention your name again, so you can stay incognito if you want to. All right, so Tina. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm good, a little bit mixed. I hear new stuff about all the situation, and it's like making me a little bit worried. Mm-hmm. But I try to be okay.
Good.
And about the superpower you were just mentioned, how to use it, I remember in the past, I even didn't know you guys. I didn't know even Faster EFT, nothing. And many times when I was worried about something, worry, and then I was sick and tired and I just give up. Like, I don't know to use different word, maybe not give up, but I say like, whatever, I don't care anymore. That's it. And you know what? I was feeling okay. It was like everything goes away from me and everything changed like automatically. So I think it's maybe the same kind of feeling, but now with the superpower might be stronger.
Exactly. Absolutely. And it is that it's surrender.
Because it's like, that, you know, you like you fight with that thing. You worry, yes. Worry, like you fight and you just give up. You just don't want to fight anymore. Just let it be as is.
Yes.
And everything fine.
Exactly. And so I had a lot of experience with that as well. Again, before I found any of this work, including the superpower, you know, I would get so despondent and so upset that I just go, well, whatever, I don't care anymore.
Yes.
And then something would happen. So yes, it's that thing of letting go of the struggle, the fighting.
The pressure, maybe anything, that stress, yeah.
Because you're wrestling with it, you're holding it in your experience.
Yes. So with the superpower, I think it's easier when you cannot let it go. It's maybe easier too.
It's easier and it makes it more consistent. It makes it smoother so that it's not this, you don't have to get to the point where you're fed up and you're rock bottom and you have to let it go. You can maintain that state. You can let it go without the drama.
Yes. Basically. Yeah. Awesome. Thank you.
Yes. You're very welcome.
I have some, I don't know if it's, I was thinking about the target today.
Yes.
So maybe it's not just for me, but for all of us to make, to target our immune system, make stronger for this virus, let's say.
Sure.
So we can become, I don't know, the immune system, our immune system can be stronger.
Yeah. Well, we can easily do that. And here's the great news, is that as long as you are in that state, targeting anything at all or nothing at all, just staying in that state, you're already boosting your immune system. So we can target it, but it's all, the great news is that every single time you go into this state of love, you're putting oxytocin into your system, which as we know from Dr. David Hamilton, boosts your immune system that moment. So the more you do it, the stronger your immune system anyway.
Excellent.
So good job. But let's add it to the list anyway, Steve, if that's all right. Oh, we can't hear you.
It wouldn't be it wouldn't be the usual if I didn't at least mute myself once there. The thing I wanted to just add one little more bit about the superpower and that feeling of letting go, that getting into that state of sending love, the unconditional love piece, is really, for me, it feels like empowerment. When we're doing that, it really is empowerment. Because when we're in that place of, I think that oftentimes we're reluctant or we feel resistant to sending love to things that we don't want because we feel like they have some sort of a power over us. It's like, I don't want to send love to something that I don't want. And I think underneath there's a belief that if I send love to it, it's going to stay or it has power over me. So being in that position of I'm going to send love to it without any expectation now puts me in a position of power. And I think it's a step up from what Tina was saying about just, you know, giving up, because I think that giving up, there's also a sense of helplessness in that, or even though you've let it go, this is letting it go, but from an empowered place.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yes, the superpower is more stronger, I found. And mostly when I visualize myself, the light from my heart.
Yes.
I feel that power.
That's it. Yes. Yeah. And it is a literal power. Yeah. And nothing. So whenever something is triggering you or whatever, if you recognize it as something that's doing something to you that immediately puts you in a weaker position. Even if you're angry and, you know, it's still a weaker position. As long as you refuse to acknowledge that that has any power over you at all, and you maintain that state of love, that shining out from your heart, you're in the strongest possible state, and you are in the most protected state that you can be in.
Yeah, good.
Very good. Thank you, Tina. Shall I call you Tina from now on?
Yeah, I'm Tina here. So
everybody else is going to think that's your real name, but that's okay. Good job. All right. Thank you, love. Okay. And going on to Kara. Hi, Kara. It's lovely to see you.
Morning.
How are you? Good morning. How are you today?
I'm great and I'm getting better.
Good job.
I would like to send love and light to the world leaders and also to the COVID-19 task force.
Very good. Fantastic. Good targets to have there. You got that, Steve? Thank you. Thank you, Kara. Lovely. And going on to the birthday girl. Hey, how are you today, Wanda?
Good. Thank you. I don't have any update, but I do have a comment. When we are sending energy to everyone in the group, I can only feel it when I send it to the pictures that are there. Mm-hmm. Like if I see a name, I kind of like don't feel sending anything. But with the pictures like Tina and Lisa and the others that I know that I look, I feel like I'm only sending it to them.
That's okay. So that's just that's just one level. You'll, as you do it more and more, you'll level up. It's just about practice.
Okay.
And, but that's good.
And the second thing is I have my picture, but I'm not too good with the Facebook thing. And who should I send it to?
Oh, email it to me and I'll forward it to Cheryl.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you. Yes. No problem at all. Good job, Wanda.
Thank you.
Thank you for sharing. All right. And then Katrina. Hey, Katrina, how are you today?
Yes.
Good. That's a good start. Yes, it's a good start.
Yes. It's interesting. It's different. This is the first time since yesterday that I have been chilled out.
Good.
From we last spoke yesterday.
Yeah.
To now. And it's amazing to me in that I always have to be like studying and revising, and so I didn't do any of that.
Okay.
You know, I was up this morning at 7 and it's now 4 and this wasn't switched on. And there was no panic and there was no nothing. And that this is okay, there's no homework done. I have nothing to say. All is good.
Good. Okay. Very good. And just keep going. Just keep. So for everyone else as well, you know, and I was saying this to someone the other day, whenever it doesn't feel the way you wish it would feel, whatever that is, so whether it's circumstances or you just don't feel nice or anything like that, see it as sore muscles from exercising. So you know how when you do a new physical exercise and then your muscles ache, it's part of the process. And those are the days when it doesn't feel so good. Then just take it easy. Don't force those sore muscles. Just go, it's okay. Today, I will just take it easy. I'm not going to force myself to do anything, including the superpower exercise. Don't force mm-hmm. yourself. Just go, I'm going to love, I love it all anyway, even if you can't feel it, just say that in your head. I love it all anyway. And I'm going to take a break. And then tomorrow, I will see if I want to get back to it. So give yourself that, because then that again, that takes the struggle and the drama out of it. Mm-hmm. And that's, you're not then forcing those sore muscles. And you're not seeing it as it's not working or I'm doing it wrong. It's just sore muscles, just part of the process. Mm-hmm. So thank you, Katrina, for sharing that. Very good. And That's everyone who's on camera. And Lisa says, when Odile and Steve first started the childhood reprogramming, how long did it take for you to change until it felt good? I'm just curious, and I know things come up and shift them as soon as you see the pattern or whatever it is. Yes. So for how long it takes, it's been a journey. So I'm going to speak from my own perspective, of course. For me, as I changed childhood memories, I mean, it was within 24 to 48 hours, probably 48 hours, when I noticed there's definitely something going on here. This is definite shift. But all my problems weren't solved. So it was just, again, it's like getting fit. So if you start physical fitness training, it doesn't go from being unfit, then you do the exercises, and then you're at the fitness level you want to be. It's a process, and this is the same. So, but it can be a lot quicker than physical fitness training, which is great. The challenge is, and I think Steve pointed this out once before, when there's something physical, like you're doing physical fitness and now your muscles are sore but you know that if you keep going, you will get fit. That's a kind of, we all know that already. With self-development, it's not as much general knowledge that the same thing happens. The same process where you start and there will be good days and bad days, but the bad days don't mean that it's not working or you're not getting anywhere. The bad days are just part of the process. And so if you keep, the physical fitness analogy is such a great one. It's really, really close to what we're doing here. So keep remembering that. And so the childhood memories, you know, we're still changing childhood memories, not anywhere near as often. And it's little tweaks here and there. But there was a lot for me, and there was a lot in the beginning, of course. There was, you know, everything. And because I had the superpower, I was living from this state of unconditional love, which made it much, much easier, number one, to change the memories, and number two, to stay on track in between. So when, you know, there were times I'd changed my financial patterns, and then suddenly I lost the writing work that was bringing in the income that I, you know, now, okay, I've changed everything. Now I'm getting an income that I wasn't getting before. And that's great. And that lasted for a period of time. And then suddenly, practically overnight, I lost the two clients I was writing for so then no income. And that was a big challenge. So that was about, was it about probably 8 months? I can't remember now because it's, you know, there's so much has happened in the meantime. But anyway, it had been like 8 to 10 months maybe of this fabulous income, and then suddenly nothing. So I had changed a lot of childhood memories, but when that happened, I could feel that tendency to think, oh, this doesn't work. This is happening to me again. And at that point, I had a choice. There was a crossroads. I could have gone, well, it doesn't work. I'm not going to do this anymore. And I could have gone down that slippery slope, but I made myself get into the superpower state and go, I cannot create anything bad for myself. And this looks really bad. It's very convincing, but I know that it has, as long as I stay in the superpower state, it has to turn out to either be good or nothing to worry about. And it's faith, it's trusting and faith, and it can be hard, but if you keep just correcting. And I got into the superpower state, and then I looked for, in fact, I had a friend help me look for the references. And it was I came across a memory of my grandmother saying, you're being greedy, talking about being greedy, and being greedy was a big thing. And so I realized that was it. I was getting momentum. So I changed the other money issue references, and now I was picking up momentum financially, and now it was all about being greedy. So I managed to change that. And again, it changed very quickly because of the superpower state. And then losing those two writing clients is one of the things that led me to creating my own course, my first email course for people. because it was like, well, what can I do now? So I did a free email course that on finances to help share that knowledge. And that led to other clients and so on. And so it took me in a different direction. Otherwise, I would still be writing for other people. So even though it looked like a bad thing, it was, as long as you go with the flow and you don't fight it, it will lead you to a different thing that you hadn't thought of before, you hadn't seen coming. So it's about staying on track. And I'm sorry, that was a very long reply to how long does it take? So it takes, I think it takes the rest of your life, but in a wonderful way. So you don't have to wait the rest of your life in order to get the results. It's just that you'll get different results. You'll go on a journey and you'll get what you want. So I now have everything I wanted. I'm in a wonderful relationship that I never saw coming. I'm living in America, which is where I'd always wanted to live. I'm doing what I love for a living. So there's all of that. And then what's the next thing? So then as Steve and I move forward to our next goals, which is doing more retreats and workshops and that kind of thing, the coronavirus turns up and that's okay. So we have to then again, love it all anyway. Look for those references. How does it feel? Are we triggered? How does it feel? Change whatever's still left there and then pivot, as they say. So then move online. And we wouldn't be doing these free sessions, these free daily sessions, if it wasn't for that, because we'd be in Chicago doing the workshop we had planned and we'd be doing the other stuff. So it's always about where you're looking as opposed to what's actually happening. So I hope that helps and answers your question. All right, very good. And let's see, Caro says, my target for today is my friend's cat, who's been run over by a car, needs a lot of love as he's in pain and under morphine. His name is Luffy. Oh, sweet. Thank you so much for your love for him. Wonderful. So you'll add that to the list. Thank you, Steve. All right, so we'll do that. Let's see what else is here. Oh, Cheryl has put her email address in the chat for those who want to send their photos for the collage. It started for me almost immediately, about 24 hours. Oh, good. Very good. And thank you for sharing that. So the results of changing memories. Fantastic. Okay, fantastic. We'll send love to the daughter that's getting the virus test back in 3 to 5 days. That's the COVID-19 test. So whether it's positive or negative, we'll send that love. Thank you. And Steve, could you add that to the list? Because that was sent to me privately, so you wouldn't have seen it. So COVID-19 test. Thank you. Very good to know. Thank you so much. So much good overflowing. You're welcome. And yes. So the person who said it took about 24 hours from starting to change childhood memories, she says, I meant to feel better. So it took her 24 hours to start feeling better. Very good. And that, you know, that is again up and down. So some days you'll feel fantastic and then another day you'll feel not good. And it's what you do then. It's what you do then when you don't feel good that makes all the difference as to how quickly you'll move forward. It's like it's driving through the storm. You know, when you're on your way to your destination, you hit a storm. If you just slow down, you know, put on an audiobook, drive more carefully, take your time until you're through the storm and get out the other side, you're going to get to your destination a lot quicker than if you pull over, get out of the car and go, I don't know how I'm ever going to get there. It's not working. I'm not there yet. And all of that, and stay in the storm, buy into the storm. Okay. So hopefully that.
Oh, Dale, I just want to add one little thing to the how long it takes thing. I know that I'm probably somebody that was always in search of the great awakening, you know, or looking for the quick fix. It's like, you know, you read all of the books and there's, you know, the only one that's coming to mind right now is like Eckhart Tolle, somebody who has this, you know, mind opening, you know, great awakening moment that just happens. And I'm like, yeah, sign me up for that. I'll take that, because, you know, that sounds like a whole lot easier than, you know, but what I know that my process has been, it's just been a process of baby steps. You know, how long did it really take? It's difficult to say, but as I look back, it's just been this process of one little baby step after another. You know, every great awakening for me just looks like another little baby step, you know? So once, you know, I discovered the, you know, the childhood memory transformation, doing that work, you know, I was engaged in that pretty solidly for about 6 months. And then when I met you and we started doing the superpower exercises, that, you know, accelerated that, it made it go, you know, so the process of actually doing that and being in that, you know, it probably was like a year, year and a half journey. But like you said, you know, it's a process. Every little step feels a little better. And, you know, you gain a little bit more momentum with that. So I kind of see my, my trophy, the award that I win, is kind of just being, you know, the gold plated baby shoes, you know, that, you know, that's my process has been that. It's just, and I think, you know, I think it's important for people to hear that and know that baby steps are okay. And it's probably the majority of us that experience, that's how we experience growth and progress.
Yeah. Yeah. Very good. And it's keeping going. As you take those baby steps to not lose faith. Very good. So let's do the exercise. Oh, sorry. I think someone had their hand up to speak just before I started.
Tina.
Tina. Hey.
I just wanted to mention, because when we start this meeting today with the exercise,
yes,
I have opened my balcony, the door completely open today, and usually the pigeon comes and make that noise, that hoo-hoo noise, and I hate it. I was like always going and scaring them, and I was in the exercise. I couldn't go, and I was sending the love to them. They disappear. It's there, you so go. Quiet. Like, I don't have to go and scare them.
There you go.
So I wanted to share this with you. Like, it was in the moment.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing that, Tina. That's a fabulous example. Perfect. Good job. All right, very good. So let's go through the, so we're going to go through the usual exercise, and we're going to aim at the targets, and then we're going to do the eyes open one, opening your eyes, and then the next step is we're going to pick one thing that irritates you a little bit. So Tina's pigeons are that's a perfect example of what you're looking for. So it doesn't have to be happening now. You can just think of something that annoys you. So let's say there were no pigeons, Tina could just think about the pigeons that annoy her and send that love. All right. So take a deep breath, close your eyes, and go into your superpower state, however you do that, using a word or phrase, or by hugging hugging your subject. And feel your heart expanding with that light shining out from it. That light, that energy shining out from your heart. Very good. And now allow that light or energy to spread down to your toes, up to the top of your head, and out to your fingertips. And fill each cell of your body with that same light, that energy. Love each cell just for existing. Very good. And now fill your subject with that same light, that energy. Love them just for existing. And now imagine they don't want to be with you, or they're being miserable or something, and keep them filled with that light, that energy anyway. Love them anyway, no matter what. Good job. And now let's fill Tina with that light, that energy, from the tips of her toes to the top of her head and out to her fingertips. Love Tina just for existing. Very good. And now to Kara. Fill Kara with that same light, that energy, that love. From the tips of her toes to the top of her head and out to her fingertips. Love Kara just for existing. And now let's allow that light or energy to overflow from Kara and fill all the world leaders with that same light, that energy, everyone, from the tips of their toes to the top of their heads and out to their fingertips. And love each world leader just for existing, shining light. Very good. And now allow that light or energy to fill the COVID-19 task force. Each person who's on the COVID-19 task force, fill them from the tips of their toes to the top of their head and out to their fingertips. So they're full of that light, that energy. Love each one just for existing, no matter what. Very, very good. Let's go back to Tina for a moment and fill Tina with that light, that energy, that love, and specifically target the immune system. Everyone's immune system. Fill it with light and energy. Love each person's immune system just for existing. Whether it works or not, whether it's good or not, love it all anyway. Shining light. Very good. And now let's go over to Caro. Fill Caro with that same light, that energy. From the tips of her toes to the top of her head and out to her fingertips. So she's full of that light or energy. Love Caro just for existing. Now allow that light or energy to overflow from Caro and fill her friend's cat, Luffy. Fill the cat with light and energy. From the tips of its paws to the tip of its head and the tip of its tail. So it's full of that light, that energy, and love, Luffy, just for existing. Exactly as it is, whether it survives or not, and no matter what, love that cat exactly as it is. Very good. And now to Wanda. Fill Wanda with that same light, that energy. From the tips of her toes to the top of her head and out to her fingertips. From the tips of her toes to the top of her birthday head and out to her fingertips. Love Wanda just for existing. Very, very good. And now to Katrina. Love Katrina, just for existing. Fill Katrina with that light, that love, that energy from the tips of her toes to the top of her head and out to her fingertips. So she's full of that light, that energy. Loving Katrina, just for existing. And loving whatever's there for her and whatever arises, love it all anyway. Shining light. Very good. And now to Lisa. Send that light, that energy to Lisa from the tips of her toes to the top of her head and out to her fingertips. So she's full of that light, that energy. Love Lisa just for existing. And think of all the childhood memories that Lisa's changing, those she's changed, those she hasn't changed, and whatever results may arise, and love it all anyway. Shine that light. This is your power. Very, very good. And now to Cheryl. Fill Cheryl with that light, that energy, from the tips of her toes to the top of her head and out to her fingertips. Love Cheryl just for existing. And now allow that light, that energy, to overflow from Cheryl and fill her daughter with that same light, that energy. Love Cheryl's daughter just for existing. And now to the results of the tests that will come back in 3 to 5 days. Fill those results with that light, that energy, that love, no matter what the result is. Love it all anyway. Shining a light, using your power. Very, very good. And now let's fill everyone else who's on this call but is off camera. Fill them all with that light, that energy, from the tips of their toes to the top of their head and out to their fingertips. Love them all just for existing. Good job. And now think of yourself as a child and love that child exactly as they are. Fill them with that light, that energy, that love. And now allow that light or energy to overflow from that little you and send it to the you later today. Imagine yourself later today, and whatever you'll be doing, however you'll be feeling, fill that version of you with that same light, that energy, that love, no matter what, exactly as you are. Very good. Now, maintaining this state of love, this light, this energy filling you, you can open your eyes if you want to and keep it going as much as you can. You can aim it at the screen, at the people on the screen, or you can aim it at inanimate objects around you. Imagine you've got this light, this energy coming out of your heart, and you're aiming it at whatever's around you. Love it all, just for existing and no matter what. Very, very good. Good job. And now I want you to think of a little target. So just something that annoys you slightly. Maybe something that's a bit irritating or that you don't like. It can be a food you don't like, a song you don't like, or anything else. Nothing too triggering, just a little bit. And think of that and maintain this feeling, and then imagine aiming this light, this energy, this love at that thing, that target, no matter what. And if you need to close your eyes again to be able to keep it going, absolutely do that. It doesn't matter if you do it with your eyes open or closed, this bit. And see how long you can, and if you lose the feeling, just bring your focus back to your heart again. Take your focus off the target, bring it back to your heart. Spread the light all the way through your body. Go back to your subject if you need to. And then once it's strong again, you can start aiming it at that little target again. So just keep, whenever you lose the feeling, it's like you've toppled over on the bike. Going back to your heart and your subject is like getting back on the bike. And here's another, an extra level for you is love. Keep yourself loved regardless of whether you're able to do that or not. So love yourself anyway, no matter what, even if you can't do the exercise. Good job. And you can open your eyes if you've got them closed. And any questions, any comments? How's everyone doing? How was that for everybody? You managed to do it? Good, 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 good. Any questions or comments or anything? Let us know. Cara? Yes.
I hadn't thought of this, but one of our dogs is having a problem with her leg, and it's been going on for a long time, and we have kept her quiet, you know, from running a lot and everything, and it's still not getting better. Could we take a minute and send some light and love to her?
Absolutely. What's her name?
Zira.
Zira? Fantastic. Yes, let's do that. Thank you. All right, everyone. So if you're still in your state, great. If you're not still in your state, you can get back into it, however you do that. Fill yourself with that power, that light, that energy, that love. And now let's aim that light or energy at Kara's dog, Zira. Fill that dog with that light, that energy, from the tips of her paws to the tip of her head, the tip of her nose to the tip of her tail. Fill her with that light, that energy completely. Love Zira just for existing. And now think of her leg and love whatever's going on there. Shine that light into all of her legs. And no matter what's going on, love it all anyway. She's perfect exactly as she is. Shine that light. Love Zira exactly as she is, just for existing. Very good. Good job. All right. And any other questions or comments or anything? How does that feel, Cara?
Really good.
Good. Yeah. Good job.
Thank you.
You're very welcome, love.
Thank you.
And give Zira a hug from us. All right. Steve?
Not sure. If Katrina had a question.
Question, yes.
Well, it's actually a comment in that the whole way through that.
Yes.
Well, 80%. I yawned.
Yes. Good.
Is that good?
It's very good. Yes. And a lot of us, I know Steve, my sister and my son, whenever I've worked with them, like especially in the beginning, whenever I was working with them, changing childhood memories, oh my goodness, they were chain yawning all the way through. And a lot of people have that. And that's part of the changes happening. So your brain is doing a lot of stuff and needing more oxygen. So it's a good sign. So sometimes it's that, and sometimes it can be resistance. Depending on what you're feeling. So I know for my sister, it was usually a sign that things were working in that. And then sometimes it was resistance where she was going, I'm falling asleep. And that's kind of trying to stop any further changes. So, but if it's just yawning, that's just getting extra oxygen. It's a very, very good sign. Some people laugh. Some people cry. There's various reactions. I know in the beginning, it doesn't happen so much anymore, but in the beginning, I used to get twitches in my legs whenever I was making significant changes to memory. So I don't know what that's about, but it's the nervous system is all connected to the brain and that, so it's all processing.
Just when you were talking about the resistance there, I made the comment whenever about keeping my eyes open.
Yes.
But you didn't tell us to keep, I had to do what I was told. So I was slightly resisting. I think, oh my God, I have to keep my eyes shut. Yes, do what you're told.
Yes. Oh, and I know that one so well. Doing what I'm told was a big one for me. So I completely get that. So it's a good opportunity to break that pattern. So one of the things, of course, is going back to your childhood and giving that little Katrina, you know, the opportunity to do as she damn well pleases. And have her parents saying to her, sweetheart, you can do whatever you like.
Well, really?
We'll love you regardless. Yes,
yeah,
okay. Absolutely. And of course, because in your mind, there's no actual real life consequences anyway.
Mm.
So you can literally do anything.
Okay. It's like, you know, it's like if I open my eyes and other people are going to see, well, she's opened her eyes. She's not doing what she's told.
Yes, yes, yes. I know that well. So now in place of that, you know, change those memories and give that little you permission to do what she wants. And then know that when we see you opening your eyes, when I haven't said open your eyes, we're actually going to think, oh, good for her. Look how well she's doing. Progress, right?
All right. Thank you.
You're welcome, love. You're very welcome. All right. And any other questions or comments before we go? So, of course, now practice this over, you know, until tomorrow. So in addition to practicing with your eyes open and that kind of thing, pick, you know, practice on those little targets that bother you just a little bit. And then once you find that easy, then pick something that bothers you a little bit more. So you're building up to the big things you actually really want to change in your life, so that you're developing that ability. So when you do the things you really want to change, you've built the skill of being able to use that unconditional bit. Wanda?
I'm going to practice on the squirrel outside that keep digging my plants. So good. I plant flowers and they go and dig them all out. So I'm going to target them.
Good job. Yes. And make sure that you're practicing filling them with love, even if they continue to dig up your flowers. That's the important bit to practice. So imagine they're digging up you, you dig up the flowers, you don't dig up your flowers. I love you all anyway. Yes. So that's a fabulous example to practice, opportunity practice. Good job, Wanda.
Thank you
for sharing it.
Pardon? Thank you to Tina. Thank you for mentioning the birth.
Yes. That's it. Good job. And thank you for sharing that as well, because it gives others an idea as well for the kind of targets that can be used. Lisa says, awesome session. Thank you, everyone. I will be sending love to you all throughout this day and every day. Thank you, Lisa. And we do the same. I meant to say as well, last night I meant to mention, I thought I must remember to mention this morning, is just so you know that I think of all of you throughout the day, and especially when I go to sleep at night. So I see you all here like this, and I send you all love, each one of you, and individually as well. So just so that you know that that's happening as well in the background. All right. Lots of love to all of you. Have a fantastic rest of your day and tonight, and we'll see you back tomorrow. All right. Bye-bye now.
Bye.